Okay, thank you very much. Unlike Philippe, I will not congratulate you because you made my life very difficult now after your presentation. I apologize, but okay, let's try to understand how perhaps the ILATU project could, why not, be a tool for possible collaboration with your researchers and our community. Then I will try to briefly present ILATU. After that, you will have a much more technical and detailed presentation by our technical coordinator, Roberto Barbera. Okay, then before, I would like to remind you some key words about the grid infrastructure, e-science, what we call a joint research unit, and the National Grid Initiative, because we are always using these terms. The outline of my presentation, I would like, profiting from the absence of Jan Foster, physical presence, I will risk myself to tell you in some slide what we consider, what is the grid, okay? Then to have networks and grid. Briefly remind you that we already had 2 years of experience in that domain, in the ILA, the first phase of the project. Then some figures about what we are doing now after 1 year of the second phase. I will try to explain to the audience how you can join or collaborate with us. And then a very, very important thing in our mind, at least at the management level, and I hope for the community, is there life after ILATU? Then the model long-term sustainability of the e-science infrastructure beyond the project. Then I would like just to show one slide, the grid paradigm. On one side, you have the scientific instruments. It could be the instruments, the John laboratory, it could be high energy physics, could be, well, whatever you want. You have some labs worldwide distributed. Then, on the other side, you have the people, because an instrument without people is no meaning, and people without instruments can do, can have a beer, but certainly not work. And these people are distributed worldwide. Between them, what we put is the grid, which is a network data processing center and middleware software at the glue of the resource. Just find some, there are a lot of definition of grid. I hope that Jan will give one, perhaps more scientific, more precise, more, but this is one. The grid is a set of computer resources spread all over the world that are shared by a user community under specific constraints. Okay. Then, therefore, interconnecting large amount of computer, virtually all the computer in the world, that are specialized managing software, the so-called middleware, one can set up computational grid infrastructure, creating an extremely powerful virtual computing environment with every institution and individual made, subscribe and run complex software package. This is a sort of evolution or revolution in computing. This is the grid revolution. You have here the resources, virtual services, and the users worldwide distributed. We have grid needs network, otherwise you cannot distribute anything. Then you have here a map of the main networks, the huge GAN network. You have here all networks stand in the Mediterranean part, and we have here in Latin America, Red Clara. In the same way, we have a global grid coverage. The coverage which is here, with a lot of grid infrastructure worldwide distributed, and in our case, the ILA, which is an European, you have here the European Commission co-funded project, and these are the other projects with other source of funding. In fact, the circle here should be a circle like that, because the ILA project is a project with a consortium with European and Latin American countries. Let's come back 3 years ago and come back to the ILA results, measure, outcome, and results. In ILA, we provide European researchers early access to new well-supported infrastructure and enable them to speed up the processing of scientific data. We strengthen the scientific community in Europe and Latin America. One good example is the collaboration between Spanish, Peruvian, and Chilean labs on the climate research. Successful building of reliable and almost production quality infrastructure in Latin America. At that time, our infrastructure was a test bed. The grid technology skills were required to autonomously support the Latin American grid on the long term, and the entrance and consolidation of Latin American community in worldwide collaboration. This was a very important outcome of ILA. And we had an amplification of the infrastructure relevance, blazing the trail towards Latin American InSCIENCE initiative and or NGIs. Just a few numbers. ILA, first phase, 21 partners, 10 countries, 7 in Latin America, 3 in Europe, international organizations. Additional CMAT funds in order to help us. Distributed the organization forward package, 1.7K CPUs, 500,000 jobs successfully executed. That means 700 CPU years delivered to the ILA users. 50 applications deployed on this infrastructure, 18 tutorials, which means about 2,000 participant days, a very, very aggressive training effort. And we managed to first create and then run 2 ILA grid schools with the concept of a standalone grid, with 30 students deployed, 12 applications in twice 10 days. Now, the present. The ILA 2 objectives and approach. The first one is build on ILA high capacity production quality, no more test bed, but production quality scalable grid facility. Ensure round the clock worldwide access to distributed computing and storage resource. Support a wide spectrum of application for both European, Latin American scientific community, industry, and commerce. This is important. Not only academia, but the life outside the university. To provide empowered grid facility with versatile services fulfilling all application requirements. And, that the reason what is red, ensure long-term sustainability of the infrastructure beyond the term of the project. What's the approach? We expand the current ILA 2 infrastructure, collaborates with NRENS, National Research Education Networks, and create regional operation center, support actively the creation of national grid initiatives, and propose a model for Latin American grid initiatives. The country and the resources in Europe on one side, and in Latin America and Caribbean on the other side. We have, as compared to ILA, we have 2 new partners in France and Ireland, in Latin America, Colombia, where we are here, and Ecuador, and one international organization with CLARA. 14 countries, 16 partners, grouped in 9 GRUs and some isolated partners. And at the beginning of the project, when we were approved by the European Commission, it was 53 members. Now, we would like, and very soon, hopefully, we will include in our consortium Panama. It has been, I signed yesterday, I received a letter for the apply, and we are currently negotiating with Uruguay. Now, the ILATU, the project in numbers. As I said, 16 GRU type partners, 6 from Europe, 9 from Latin America, 1 international, 14 countries, 53 institutions. EC support a little bit higher, but a lot of institutions. And again, special funds coming from CIEMAT to help us. Now we have 6 activities in the project: management, dissemination, training, applications, support, infrastructure. I will show that. So, 30 resource centers, 3,000 computing nodes, 700 terabytes of storage. This has been written in the description of work, the proposal. And I should say that we are not now at this level, but hopefully during the second year we will reach these figures and beyond. The foreseen growth of the project duration of this is 20% in computing and 15% in storage. This is a big challenge, but we are quite confident that thanks to the collaboration, the commitments, and the proactive participation of the members, we will succeed to do that. We are planning to deploy about 50 applications that were selected. And biomedical domain, high energy physics, obviously, because the grid starts there, earth science, climate, e-learning, e-government, e-industry, and others. How, since we have different middleware, different project worldwide distributed, a very important issue is interoperability, and we already signed MOUs between general MOU on green interoperability between ILATU, SIGRID SCI project, and UTIC laboratory in Tunisia. We are negotiating with other institutions. At the very beginning of the project, we made a survey, a scientific, in order to have an idea of the application that will run on the infrastructure. And 98% were scientific application. Then there is a consensus that the grid model is useful and should open new perspective for application. The question was about the scientific, and this is a number of people who agree on that. The same here for the social matters. 55% declare that half of the application about will have positive outcomes socially. In biomedicine, obviously, 82%. High energy physics, it's not quite obvious. Earth science, 70%. Okay, and there's some comment, interesting comment. Running biomedicine and science application on ILATU will substantially contribute to enhance their socially useful results. For the industry, 80% of the answer was positive, that a rather large fraction of applications claim to induce industry spin-off. 91% biomedicine, 71% in high energy physics with very, very high tech technology here with a spin-off in the industry, earth science too, okay? In fact, basically, no industry sector concerned by ILATU application is currently using the green model. The current situation, hopefully it will change. Study are outsourced to university team which use a grid for high efficiency. The challenge now is to get industries, especially SMEs, to use our infrastructure. How to collaborate with us? You can find all the necessary information in our website here. And there is two ways. Either you try to join the project, to be a new member of the project, or you just want to collaborate with us. Then you have to fill a survey, and then you have two alternatives. If the country already hosts an ILATU joint research unit, you get in touch with this joint research unit, and then we sign a memorandum of understanding, or the technical management of the project will discuss and approve, hopefully. If the country hosts a single partner, or the country is a new, for instance, there is no ILATU partner in it, which is the case in the Panama, Uruguay, and other possible contacts, the direct contact will be established between the new institution and the ILATU, and if it applies, the ILATU single partner in the country will be involved in the discussion. If in a non-ILATU country several institutions are willing to collaborate, willing to join project, they will ask it to create a GRU signing MOU, which is the case, for instance, of Panama. Now, I don't want to spend a lot of time about that. This is quite boring, but the joint research units, the slide will be uploaded, you will have time to consult this slide and to just consult all the interesting things here at the link. National Grid Initiative, too, I will not spend much time on that. It's a legal organization, unlike the GRU, which is non-legal. This is, let's say, much more serious, and this is one of the tools we should use to our long-term sustainability. Information about that could be found here. What we are proposing now as model for the life beyond the ILATU project is to have possible at the national level in Latin America, university research organization laboratories federated in the National Grid Initiative with the management board, with the director, grid operations center, project coordination, dissemination, training, application support, finance. A strong liaison with the NRL must be established. Local condition permitting, NGI, National Grid, the grid world and the network world can merge into a single entity, which is politically correct in our minds and certainly cost-effective instead of having two parallels. This is at the national level. Then we have to think about the long-term sustainability. ILA, first phase, ILA, second phase, and then what could happen. Then this is the model with, I think that Roberto will talk again about that. Here, the Latin American Grid Initiative with Grid Support Center. Here, the network counterpart with the Network Support Center. In small countries with a few resource centers, they will be directly linked to the catch-all here. And for big countries with a lot of centers, you will have National Grid Initiative with Grid Operations Center and Network Operations Centers. Okay, here are the three levels, from the bottom to the top. You have the institute level, okay, with the resource centers, the backbone. Intermediate level, national, with the National Grid Initiative, Grid Operation Center, okay, and the upper level, international, at the continental level. Then the model is based essentially at three levels, institution, country, continent. Something similar at the Latin American level, with a federation of all the NGIs in all the countries, with LGI Council, executive director, and at the same figure we had for the national level. Grid Support Center, network, coordination, dissemination, training, application, finance. This model should could be implemented with the ideal figures in terms of full-time equivalent. Here, the funding source at the local level, national level, and here, Latin American level. This is not million, billion, it's not euros, not dollars, it's just persons, men, full-time equivalent. At conclusion, I think that we can say that ILA was a success. It has been recognized by the highest EC ranking at the final review. ILA certainly changed the perspective about e-science in Latin America. The mature grid empowered ILA test bed improved scientific collaboration between Europe and Latin America. So climate, for instance, was a good example. And the first ILA 2 year indicates that the ramp-up of all activity and the commission of production infrastructure will boost the use of the services. We are at least dreaming of that. And the dream comes true. Then, for us, the long-term sustainability implies extra funding. This is very important to work now just to prepare the future. In collaboration with Europe, European institution, but perhaps without such big support from the European Commission. But the long-term sustainability of the infrastructure worldwide is key for continued support of scientific community. ILA 2 has defined the model as the architecture of the Latin American Grid Initiative, similar to the European Initiative. So we adapted a model proposed in Europe to the Latin American situation, a reality. It's obvious that Latin American countries should start as soon as possible the creation of the NGIs. Otherwise, long-term sustainability will be a dream, that's all. And ILA 2 knows how could perfectly be exported through its powerful and comprehensive training program, for instance, the grid school, in any country, even non-ILA country. We organize tutorials in non-ILA institutions and in non-ILA country, for instance, in Africa. ILA 2 is willing to share resources and knowledge with other institutions from other communities. And this new collaboration is usually established by a memorandum of understanding. Then now, we would like to forward to either welcome you in ILA 2 as a new member, it's in the course, or collaborate with you via MOU. Thank you for your attention.